Hi students, assalamu alaikum. This is Waqar Ahmed, and today in this lecture video we are going to discuss about the morphology and body feature of bacterial body. Here in this video we discuss about the all the body features of the prokaryotic living organisms, and we start our lecture from the size of bacteria. If we discuss about the size of prokaryotic living organism, these living organisms are all the microscopic in nature. Mean we can't see them with the help of our naked eye. Because of prokaryotic cell, they are much more simpler, much more smaller organization of the cells, or some much more smaller creature of the world. These are basically the ancestor of all the higher organisms or the life, but they still have a smaller body. If we discuss about the size of bacteria, the size of bacteria is always less than 3 micrometer. And they are mostly visible only under the microscopes, and we can see them with the help of our routine compound microscopes. And they have a variety of shape in the bacteria. We discuss them after the size of bacteria. That's about the size. That's the bacteria have much more smaller, they are microscopic, and they always have size less than 3 micrometer. If we discuss about the shape of bacteria, we get three main or three basic type of bacteria. Some bacteria have spherical, some have rod shaped bacteria, some have curved shape bacteria, or the simple comma shaped bacteria, we can say that. If we discuss about the shape of bacteria, first of all we discuss that some bacteria have the spherical shape, and such type of bacteria which have spherical or rounded shape are known as the cocci bacteria or the coccus bacteria. Similarly, we also found that some bacteria have the cylindrical shape, they have cylindrical body, rod like structure. And such bacteria are more known as or categorized at the bacilli, in category of bacillus. We also found some other bacteria which have spiral in shape, or the spiral body. If we discuss about the spiral bacteria, these bacteria have the body of comma like or the comb like body. If we discuss about the spiral bacteria, and they have somehow curved like body as compared to the other bacteria. That's the classification of bacteria. We divide the bacteria into three main classes. That's are the spherical bacteria, that's are the cylindrical bacteria, and last one is the spiral bacteria. Spiral bacteria, spiral kits, etc. Also the forms of this group. Now we move toward the natural structure of bacteria. Mean the bacterial body, which type of organelles the bacterial body contain, etc. We are now moving to discuss about these things. If we discuss about the bacterial body, are the prokaryotic cells, and as a prokaryotic cell, bacteria contain following important parts. First one is the cell wall. Cell wall is the outermost and most important part of bacterial cell bacterial body, which mostly made up of murine, peptidoglycan, etc. And some bacteria does not contain any type of cell wall. On the basis of cell wall, we divide bacteria into three types. That's of the archaebacteria, which does not contain peptidoglycan in their cell wall, and they contain the alcohol in their cell wall. While the some bacteria, this myoplasma bacteria, are the normal day bacteria, they contain the peptidoglycan in their cell wall. Eubacteria actually contain the peptidoglycan in their cell wall, while the third bacteria is the myoplasma, which does not contain any type of cell wall. On the basis of cell wall, we have three type bacteria. That are the archaebacteria, oldest bacteria, new bacteria, the modern day bacteria, and the myoplasma does not contain any type of cell wall. If we discuss about the cell wall is about 20% dry weight of bacteria. Mean it contain about 20% dry weight of bacteria. Similarly, cell wall is 0.1 micron to 0.5 micrometer thicker layer. It grows rapidly. It means its growth is much more faster in the younger bacteria as compared to the older one. As the age of bacteria increases, then the tendency of growth of the cell wall will be decreases. The main layers of the bacterial body are the peptidoglycan, lipoprotein, phospholipids, and lipopolysaccharide. These are the some important layers which are present in the bacterial cell walls. And on the basis of these cell walls, we again have some other categories of bacteria, or we categorize bacteria into some other groups. These groups are the gram-positive bacteria as well as the gram-negative bacteria. This category of gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria is much more important from pathogenic point of view, because in the pathology, the gram-positive and gram-negative classification is mostly used for identification of bacteria and for also for the for the selection of different drugs against the bacteria, etc. If we discuss about the gram-positive bacteria have only two layers, not these three, these four layers in present in gram-positive. These bacteria have only two layers in their body. These are the cell wall, these are the lipopolysaccharide and the teichnic acid. These two layers are just two layers are present in the body of gram-positive bacteria. But the gram-negative bacteria, which we are now, are more, much more pathogenic, and they have much